active. Now, as Andy mentioned earlier, Steve Winwood's now been making records for over 20 years. He had his first hit when he was 17 with the Spencer Davis Group. He then veered off to produce some wonderful psychedelic pop with Traffic. He then formed the not-quite-so-wonderful supergroup Blind Faith with Eric Clapton, and then he went solo, living in almost total seclusion in the Gloucestershire countryside and bunging out an LP every now and again entirely written, played and produced by himself, but not so the new one. The latest album has actually got other musicians on it, and what's more, its author has been found straying far from his own home on one occasion by this man. Richard, where exactly was it?
Well, Mark, it wasn't Los Angeles, it wasn't New York, it wasn't even Nashville. This exotic location was just a few hundred yards away from this studio, in a pub here in beautiful downtown Shepherd's Bush. Inside, Steve Winwood, a piano, and a song made famous by Traffic.
I recorded alone, pretty much alone, and I did the engineering and I played the instruments and everything. And so this time I wanted to, I wanted to get involved with more people, musicians, engineers, work with a co-producer, and I recorded in New York.
A list of the people you collaborated with. People like Chaka Khan, James Ingrams, Nile Rodgers, Jocelyn Brown, Joe Walsh, Steve Ferroni and Randy Brecker.
Well, with regard to Joe Walsh, we've been friends for quite a time. You know, we've been talking about doing something, and he played a couple of cuts on the album that I'd already done, and we wanted to write something. We got together one night, got in a few beers, and stayed up all night and wrote three songs.
Seems to me, listening to the album, that you've sort of rediscovered a lot of the R&B roots that maybe you discarded for a while.
Yeah, I think so. Definitely. What can I tell you? I can't say why, but it just felt like I felt that I wanted to, get back into those old R&B kind of feels. I think. You know, I grew up listening to all that, and it's very important, and it's great stuff. You know, I think it's good stuff. Mm-hmm.
20 years of making music, what do you think of the current chart situation now? Do you find yourself a pop fan still?
Oh yeah, I think some good bands around.
Singers too.
And some good singers, yeah. I saw, when I was in New York, I saw Simply Red playing at the Ritz, and they were fantastic. You know, like Level 42, I mean, Go West, some great bands were out.
What about the success of Phil Collins?
Ah, fantastic. I mean, he's a monster, isn't he?
There are people who have drawn parallels in style between him and you.
Well, yes, that's all I can say is a great compliment.
We haven't had much in the way of fast and furious axe licks on this programme since the days when Randy California used to be on about every 10 minutes, but this you will enjoy, I guarantee. Martin Stephenson playing an instrumental